Created the World Health Organization International Society of Hypertension Cardiovascular Risk Predictions in a cohort of Sri Lankans. There are many cardiovascular risk prediction models in the world. However, there are no specific models derived mainly of developing countries. And Sri Lanka, we do not have a model derived of our own cohorts. Therefore, we use the charts developed by WHO. So WHO and International Society of Hypertension has developed risk prediction charts for different epidemiological regions. And there we are grouped with Thailand, Indonesia, and Malaysia-like countries under Southeast Asia region. There are two main types of charts, like with cholesterol and without cholesterol, to be used in resource poor settings, the without cholesterol one. But none of these charts are validated among Sri Lankans. Therefore, we aim to validate the WHO ISHCRB risk chart in a cohort of Sri Lankans, and also to compare the agreement risk in risk predictions between the WHO charts with cholesterol and without cholesterol. So in 2007, we studied a population-based cohort of Sri Lankans. This was part of a sub-study of Agama Health Study. Our study cohort was participants between 40 to 64 years, selected by stratified random sampling. Of the Ragama MOH area. So in each and every patient, we calculated their 10-year cardiovascular risk predictions using both the with cholesterol and without cholesterol charts of the WHO charts. Then again in 2017, after 10 years, we evaluated the same cohort to identify the onset of new onset cardiovascular events. Over that 10-year period. We then compared the 2007 risk predictions with the actual observed events in 2017. So our patient cohort consisted of 2,517 patients. Mean age was 53, 45% were male, and majority 96% were Sinhalese. And if you look at the pie chart, this shows the predicted cardiovascular risk distribution within our cohort, the predictions in 2007. So here we have stratified patients into several risk categories, less than 10, 10 to 19, 20 to 29, 30 to 39, and the ones who have more than 40% risk. You can see the majority, 81%, had a low risk, less than 10%. And if you take the sample above 20 or more than 20% risk, the percentage was 9.4%. So what it means is 9.4% of this population is at high risk of developing a cardiovascular event in next 10 years time. Then we followed up these patients after 10 years in 2017, and we identified 215 new cardiovascular events within that cohort. There were 142 non-fatal events and 73 fatal events. So with that, the observed cardiovascular event rate was like 215 upon 2517, it was 8.5%. And then you remember the predicted risk more than 20% was 9.4%, going fairly together. So we validated the WHO-ISH risk predictions with our observed events. So we tried several models, like we classified, stratified patients according to their risk into five categories, like less than 10 up to more than 40. Or we classified them into three groups and also into two groups. And this was the model that came best predictive. So if we classify people taking the cutoff as 20, less than 20 and more than 20, so the observed events all were within the predicted event range, except this red area where the high-risk females risk was over predicted by WHO score. Like the actual risk they we observed was 15.3%, but WHO score with that it was more than 20%. But the rest were in agreement. Then we the next step, we compared the WHO risk predictions using the chart without cholesterol and with cholesterol. So the first column is without cholesterol and the rest is with cholesterol. So the pink highlighted cells are the ones that shows agreement, like the both risk score says, like if it is 10% or both scores say it's 10%. And we found that 81% of our patients were within those cells. So like there was a 80% agreement between the two scores. And statistically, it was significant. And with Kappa statistics, it was Kappa was 0.042, showing a moderate association. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, in conclusion, so the first thing is WHO-ISH risk prediction charts. They do provide good 10-year cardiovascular risk predictions in Sri Lankans. However, predictions are best in male than in females. And when the patients are stratified into just two groups, low risk and high risk, taking 20% as the cutoff. And the second conclusion is both the WHO risk charts with and without cholesterol are in moderate agreement.
Now, we have two questions. Right. Congratulations on a well-conducted study. I think we must appreciate that it's a long-term study and involving large number of patients. My question is, I think particularly in a long-term study and involving large number of patients, the validity of the results depend on the degree of follow-up. So what was the percentage of follow-up of your cohort over the 10-year period?
Madam, actually, our starting cohort was 2,958. Okay. But this 2,517, we were able to follow up for the whole period.
Right.
So there is 100% follow-up in this 2,000. 970.
So, but if you started off with 2,900, then there is about 400 missing.
Yes, yes, madam. Yes. They were lost to follow.
We tried
several ways to contact them, but we could not contact them, so we excluded them.
So, right. Did you have diabetes patients with diabetes in your room?
Yes.
And hypertension?
Yes. So, like initial the eligibility criteria was only the age. Like anybody in that employee area between 35, so the initial group was 35 to 64 years, but why is it 40 to 64 years was, madam, because like all the
applications are they certified after about 40, so that's why he took that.
So do you think this is good enough, or do we have to develop our own?
I think, madam, we need to develop our own one, because like I need so it obviously so that it the previous was underestimated, and then so like and here because like the WHO score is made for like low risk settings, so they have just used the total cholesterol only in the first one. I think like so we are far better in our healthcare system. We should be able to like incorporate even the HDL, like the very predictive cholesterol values, and if we can develop another model specifically for us, I think that would be better than this.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, I know.